Welcome back to Freshalicious. My name is Presha Bharti and welcome back to episode number 6 of Dates Gone Wrong. Mumbai se aaya random boyfriend. So I was going through a friend list on Facebook and I came across this guy who I found a tad bit cute. So I sent him a friend request. I was in college second year at this time. So he sent me a hi and I was like, okay, this cute guy wants to talk to me. Yay! So I messaged him, hi, what's up? And then we started talking. I won't say it was an instant connection. There wasn't any romantic connection as such. But whatever it was quite fun. And then we started playing truth or dare. Then we got to know about each other a little bit. And then he gave me a dare to change my relationship on Facebook to an open relationship with him. Frankly speaking, at that time, I did not know what an open relationship means. So I was like, oh, that's not a big deal. I'll just do it. And I did it. And he said, I have to keep it for 7 days. So I changed my relationship status from single to in an open relationship with this guy. So I gave him the same dare to change his relationship because obviously if I'm putting on Facebook and if some of our mutual friends check his status and if it's gonna say single, then it's gonna be a little weird for me. So I just asked him to do the same. He also changed his status from single to open relationship. And I swear at that time, I actually thought open relationship means that we are in a relationship and we are sharing it out in the open. Sharing it out as in like we are letting people know that here we are in a relationship. So it's out in the open now. That is what I thought open relationship meant. We started talking a lot and within 3 days of us talking to each other, he was like, I'm gonna visit you in Delhi. I was like, oh, that's great. That was just so quick. He booked his ticket the same day. The next day was Diwali. He visited me on Diwali. So like in the morning, his flight landed and then I went to the airport to receive him. And then we went to the place where he was staying. I dropped him there and then I went back to my place because obviously like it was a Diwali day. I couldn't have stayed with him. He was there for 2 days. It sounds mean that he came to visit me, but I am choosing to spend my Diwali time with my family. But that's how things happen in my family. I cannot leave my home on Diwali. The entire day I was with my family. For the evening, I went out with him, had dinner, and then the next day we toured the entire city. I had to show him around because he was coming to Delhi for the first time. It was sweet of him to like visit me, but at the same time it was quite weird because it was just the fourth day of us talking and getting to know each other. It was kind of a relationship because we were calling each other boyfriend, girlfriend. Then when we went to Khan Market, I was like, it's a sweet gesture. I think I should buy him a gift. I bought him a gift and then in return, he also bought me a gift. I was like, okay, like, sweet. So he was a lawyer. He seemed like a person who took his work very seriously and who was kind of a geek in a way. And he bought an expensive Swarovski pen for his boss. I got a little chamcha vibes from him. I mean, it's mean to say, but what do I know? I was in college. I was just goofing around with my life at that point. Then we came back to his place and he had to leave for his flight. I left him and I did feel quite bad. You know, I have that, even though if I meet you for one day, but when it's time to say goodbye, I kind of have that separation sadness in me. I won't say separation anxiety, but separation sadness in me. Of course, like he was sweet enough to come visit me and then meet me for 2 days. The entire 2 days of his trip and me meeting him was really sweet and really warm. And so then he left and I felt quite sad after that. The next day we spoke for a while and then it was very mutual. The next day, I didn't call, he didn't call. Then the next day, I didn't call, he also didn't call. Then the next day, I didn't call or message, nor did he call or message. And then slowly and steadily after that, we never spoke to each other. Like, it wasn't that we unfriended each other on Facebook or we had a bitter exchange of text or we had fight over the phone call. Nothing of that sorts happened. Just the day he left, the next day we spoke, okay, you reached, okay, so they like the gifts and stuff you bought from Delhi. Oh, did you like Delhi? And yeah, everything went well. And then, boom. I think it was mutual. It was very much mutual. How do I explain it? You know, when you feel something, the person feels the same thing. It just collides in such an amazing manner where you just grow apart without making other person feel bad about it or without just any drama or any sadness. You just grow apart. It was that, and I think we're still friends on Facebook. I don't know, I haven't checked since then. Like, I dated him for 7 days. We came into a relationship without really announcing it, and we got out of the relationship without really announcing to each other as well. I won't say it's a date gone wrong. I think the date went well, but the story did somewhere I felt went wrong, because if the attraction and if the connection was that real, it would have stayed and none of us would have ghosted each other. But both of us did. I don't know, some relationships are just so random and blah. Which brings us to the end of episode number 6. I hope you guys enjoyed the story. I really enjoyed sharing the story with you guys. If you guys like this video, please go ahead and hit the thumbs up button and subscribe to my channel and comment. I will see you guys tomorrow with episode number 7 of Dates Gone Wrong. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye. If I could make you see my wounded heart, you might realize what's the hardest part.